following program is from NET, the Public Television Network.
You came today. Everybody's trying to help me learn my alphabet today, but I seem to be having trouble with one of the letters. Maybe you can help me.
You keep getting stuck on that one particular letter, don't you?
That's right.
Well, yeah. We'll figure out.
Yeah, one that goes like this, Big Bird.
Yeah, like this, Big Bird. Look.
Dig the circle? Like that.
Oh, yeah.
Like a circle. You know?
But I can't think what it's called.
Oh, here's Bob.
Making lazy circles?
Yes, we're making lazy circles. Big Bird's having trouble learning a letter.
The one that's shaped like that, huh?
That's right,
Bob.
Right. And you can't figure out
no, we
what
can't.
To do.
No.
I've got it.
You
what?
Have?
I've got it.
What?
I've got the solution right here.
Traveling transistors. It's a walkie-talkie.
Good guess, Gordon.
Wow.
Listen. Sesame Street to Skywriter. Sesame Street to Skywriter. Over.
Alfie and Bates, the Skywriter to Sesame Street. Go ahead.
Where is he?
He's up there.
Sesame Street to Skywriter. Big Bird needs to see a letter to help him learn the alphabet. The one that is round like a circle. Got it? Over.
Roger. I'll be over right away. Okay. Get it?
Over. Roger. Roger. Okay.
Good thinking, Bob. This should solve the problem.
Oh,
yes.
There he is.
Oh, look.
There he is.
Up there in the sky.
There he is.
It's a bird.
No, it's not.
It's a plane.
Yes,
right.
It is.
It's a plane.
And it's making a letter.
All right, now what letter is that,
okay.
Bird? What
now,
letter is that?
I see the letter. It's a W.
No.
Wrong.
J-K-L-M.
Yeah.
Oh, my. I can't think of what that is.
Come on, Big Bird.
Come on.
It's certainly not a B.
No.
It's much like a donut.
Wait a minute. Look. It is a circle.
Now, what is that called?
Oh, wait a minute. I think I know what it is.
What?
Of course. It's an O.
Oh.
It's an O. Everybody here knows their ABCs, right?
Yeah. Now,
even Big Bird, you know, he learned his ABCs.
I did.
A good way to practice ABCs is to sing it. So, Big Bird, are you ready to sing your ABCs?
Yes, I am,
Susan. We'll check him out, see if he knows it. Sing loud, Big Bird.
Okay.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G. H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P. Q, I, S, T, U, V. W,
at home to sing out loud. If you don't know all your ABCs, sing the ones you know, but sing loud, okay? Okay, let's sing again.
A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, Q, R, S, T, U, V, W, X, Y, and Z. Now we know our ABCs. Next time, won't you sing with me?
Oh, hey, that was very good. Wasn't that good for Big Bird? Big Bird, you know, if you keep on practicing your ABCs, you're going to be able to say your alphabet with all the finesse of James Earl Jones.
Wow.
Well, you know what he loves to eat?
Sugar.
He loves sugar, and also he loves carrots. Watch, if you put it right on your hand like that. Oops, he dropped that one. I'll give him another piece there. Oh, having a hard time here. Okay. There we go. All right, pick that one right up off the street. You ever been this close to a really big horse? Hey, you know how you tell, you know how they measure horses, how big they are? Well, Coffee Cake is about 7 years old, and they measure them from their shoulder, which is right over here, to the floor, by the number of hands. So they say that this Coffee Cake is 15 hands high. Because if you took your hands and put them from his shoulder, right up here, down to the ground, he'd be about 15 hands high. He likes you, Josh. They have something like us, too. You know, on their feet, they wear shoes just like we do. Only the shoe is made out of metal, and his hooves are sort of like our nails.
And he chews around.
Right. And they clip his nails every once in a while. Oh, and you know what this is called up in here? This hair right between his eyes? Well, that's part of his mane. That's called a forelock. And what is between his eyes, Josh? If you're looking at them sort of straight on, What his nose is between his eyes, right? Hey, you know all about between, don't you? Hey, Susan, why don't you sing a little song?
Okay.
Maybe called Here Are Some Things?
That belong together. Here are some things that belong together. Here are some things that are kind of the same. Here are some things that belong together. And now it's time to play. Okay, look at these things over here. One of these things belongs with the others. See if you can guess which one. Guess which thing belongs with the others. But do it before my song is done. Okay, let's look and make sure we know what we have over here. Now this is a book, a newspaper, the Daily Grouch, and a stop sign. Now look over here at these three things and try and figure out which one should be right here. Figure out why these are kind of the same. You think you got it? Okay, we'll see. Which of these things goes with the others? Do you think this one might? Well, if you guess that this thing goes with the others, you know, you're absolutely right. Okay, we'll put it right over here. Mm-hmm. Now, Bob, why does this comic book belong over here by the street sign?
Well, I think that belongs there because these are all things that you can read, right?
A book,
the Daily Grouch newspaper, a comic book, and the stop sign. You have to be able to read the words
S-T-O-P
that says
to know
stop.
That it's stopped.
Right, so you don't
Very
get hit
good.
With a car,
well, what
right?
What about these two things here?
Well, this is a glass of water or milk or something like that, and this is an apple, and you can't read a glass or an apple
no,
very well.
No,
right?
Eat those for lunch.
Hey, that's kind of a nice game. Could I try one?
Yeah, go ahead.
This one here?
Yeah, do this
All
one
All right.
Here.
Let's see, what have we got here?
I don't think
All right, see how you do on these. Well, here are some things that belong together. Here are some things that are kind of the same. Here are some things that belong together. And now it's time to play our game. Okay, take a close look now at these things. 'Cause one of these things belongs with the others. See if you can guess which one. Guess which thing belongs with the others. But do it before my song is done. Okay, now take a very close look at all the things we have over here. We have some, what are these, Sue?
Rollhouse cookies.
Cookies! And here we have a delicious ham sandwich. And down here a nice, cherry vanilla ice cream. And one of these things over here belongs over here. Think you know which one? Which of these things goes with the others? Do you think that this one might? Well, if you guess that this thing goes with the others, then you're absolutely right.
Ah,
very good.
Banana.
Hey, they're getting pretty smart. Now, tell me, why does the banana belong over in
well,
this group?
Well, you almost have everything here for lunch. You have a sandwich and cookies and a banana and an ice cream cone that Mama told you not to eat because she put a banana in your lunch.
See? You guessed. And why don't these things belong over there?
Oh, well,
what does the spoon do?
Well, you use the spoon to eat with. It's an implement to eat with. And mm-hmm. you use the chair to sit down at the table. But here's what you have for lunch, right?
You're getting pretty smart at this game. You're doing
very,
very well. You did well on that riddle.
These are three little baby chickens that you're petting, and they're 5 days old, and they're called bantams, and this is their mother. See, she's full grown, but she's very little. And she's called a hen, and the father would be...
Hmm? Where's the fox?
Oh, I don't know, but he would be called a rooster. What were you going to say about her? She's a pretty color, isn't she?
Yeah. I was going to say monticles.
Huh?
I was going to say monticles.
Look at the difference in the kind of food that the babies can eat and what she can eat. See?
She likes her water.
She likes to drink the water along with her scratch grain. She's eating cracked corn and wheat. And the babies' food is all...
smashed up.
Yeah, very small because they're little. They have little mouths. Lisa, come back over on this side.
And then the big one. What's this stepping in?
Hmm? Uh-oh. Uh-oh. Watch out, Mother.
Mm-hmm. Come over here, Mother Goose.
No, that's not a goose. That's a chicken. A Mother Goose is another kind.
Okay. You ready?
Yeah.
You don't even know what you're ready for.
A game.
A game? Well, what kind?
Peaches.
Peaches?
Pictures.
Oh, pictures, yeah. Okay. That's what. But what kind of game we're going to play with the pictures?
Airplanes? No.
Airplanes? No. It's called What Happens Next. Don't you know about What Happens Next?
Yeah.
For instance, for example, if you looked at him, what's going to happen next?
He's
going to jump in the water. And will he stay dry?
No.
He'll get wet. I suppose it's dry water, though.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. See him?
Yeah.
Little boy. He got an ice cream cone?
Yeah.
What's
going to
happen?
He's going to eat it.
He's going to eat it. You got that, Lisa. That was good. That's exactly what he's going to do. He's going to eat it. Okay, now watch this. Whip out this one. There.
He's going to catch it. The little boy played basketball.
No, that's
baseball.
Baseball. Okay, Lance, and you have to handle that kind of stuff, okay?
And he's gonna catch the ball.
Yeah, he's gonna catch the ball. All right, go along with that. But just happen to have a tricky one. What's gonna happen next?
The airplane's gonna turn over.
Wait, you said the airplane's gonna turn over. Now,
it's gonna land.
Lisa, you could be right.
It's gonna take off.
You could be right, Gillian.
It's gonna go up in the sky.
Lance, it's gonna land. All of those things are possible. That's because of the way the picture is, you see? Because Lisa said it's gonna turn over. Well, you know, one wing's a little tipped over on one side, and that's a possibility. You said it was gonna land, Gillian?
No.
You said it was gonna take off?
Yeah.
Could be taking off. You said, who said it was gonna land? You did, Lance, okay. That's a possibility too.
I said it's gonna go up in the air.
And you said it was gonna go up in the air, Troy. And you could have been right. You know that?
Well, who was right?
Who was right? Everybody was right because you saw it through your own eyes the way you wanted to see it. What is going on there? Oscar! What are you doing? What's going on?
Well, I'm grouchy. And I want to be sure that everybody knows it.
So what's new, Oscar? You're usually grouchy.
Yeah, but today, I'm so grouchy that I have written a song to celebrate it.
A song about grouchiness?
Yeah, would you like to hear it?
No, thank you very much.
No, I don't want to hear the song about
being
grouchy.
Good, good, then I'll sing it.
I figured.
Okay, music, please. If you're grouchy and you know it, make some noise. Grouchy and you know it, make some noise. If you're grouchy and you know it, make some noise. Or let's show it. Woo! If you're grouchy and you know it, make some noise.
Oscar's grouchy. You know, though, I had to tell you. Now, look, there are lots of ways to tell how somebody feels. Look at their face, the way they walk, the way they talk. You can even tell a lot from just watching a pair of hands, you know?
Oh, now we're going to do a song. First, you stand up. Stand up, everybody, and just jump around to the beat. Got it? Now, I'm going to sing some lyrics, and I'm going to give you instructions, and you do everything I do, okay? Ready? Ready, gang? Okay. Rub your tummy just like this. Rub it all day long. Rub your tummy not too hard while we sing our song. Rub, dub, 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 dub. Okay, now the next verse is going to be pat your head. So get all ready to do that, okay? Pat your head just like this. Pat it all day long. Pat your head, but not too hard. And sing our silly song. Pat, 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 pat. I got a hard one for you because you got to rub your tummy and pat your head at the same time. Can you do that? Rub your tummy, pat your head, play and sing along as we sing our very, very, merry, merry silly song. Clap your hands just like this. Clap them all day long. Clap your hands with a one, two, three while we sing our
wasn't it? Ladies and gentlemen, step right up. But don't be shy. My dear friends, I repeat, don't be shy. You have here before you the greatest letter in the English language. Oh, pardon me. One of the greatest. It is the useful, graceful, adorable, ever popular letter E. Let me point out to you, my dear friends, that the letter E comes in two sizes. One, two, count them. Two sizes. The capital E and the small E. Sorry, but my E's are a little stage shy. Now, as I was saying, my dear friends, the letter E comes in two sizes. The capital E with the strong straight lines. Zap, zeep, zope, zoop. And the small E with the graceful curving line. And a little zip right here in the middle. Goodness me, I seem to be having a little technical difficulty. Well, we'll straighten that out. There you are. I repeat, there you are. Now, as I was saying before, and I was telling you that the letter E comes in two sizes, the capital E and the small E. E! One, two, three. Take it easy. Count to ten, Hooper. Mr. Hooper, count to ten. Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten. We have returned, my dear friends, and we have returned with the finest constructed letters in the English alphabet. We have taken care of all technical difficulties, and we have come back to you with the important capital E and a little E, and nothing can go wrong. Nothing. Nothing. My dear friends, I repeat, goodbye. Please come back again. We shall have some better ease next time. Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters E, O, and V, and by the number 10. Sesame Street is the production of the Children's Television Workshop.
This is NET, the Public Television Network.